In this illustration, we'll again solve a circuit having cubical frame structure with capacitors. So here we are given that the figure shows a cubical wireframe with 12 capacitors, similar to the previous illustration. But here we are required to find the equivalent capacitance of the circuit between terminals A and C. All capacitors are of capacitance C that we'll take. So here, if we apply a 100 volt battery for nodal analysis, then we can take potential on one side as 0, on another side it is 100. So in this situation, if we distribute the potentials, here we can see if this 100 and this 0 potential at point B can be directly taken as 50, here also it can be taken as 50. If at node G potential is taken as X by symmetry, at E it will be 100 minus X. Similarly, again at point F and H, potential can be taken as 50 and 50 because they are at same distance or same separation from 0 and 100 volt. So we just need to calculate one variable for which we can write the equation. So here equation for X can be given as the sum of these three plate charges equal to 0. The charge on this capacitor will be C multiplied by X, plus charge on this will be C multiplied by X minus 50, plus charge on this is C multiplied by X minus 50, which should be 0. Here C gets cancelled out. Solving, we are getting 3X is 100, so the value of X is 100 by 3 volt. Now we can find out the charge flown through battery, which is delta QF. And the amount of charge which is flown through battery will be there on these three capacitors, it will be deposited. So this can be written as C multiplied by X plus C multiplied by 50 plus C multiplied by 50, because these two capacitors are having a potential difference of 50 volt and this is CX. So this will be C multiplied by, this will be 100 by 3 plus 100. So here this is C multiplied by 400 by 3. So capacitance across terminals A and C can be given as delta QF by 100. So this will be C multiplied by 400 by 3 divided by 100, which will give us 4C by 3. That is the answer to this problem. Now in this illustration also you can solve it by using the alternative method which we have discussed in the previous illustration, that is by converting the circuit into equivalent circuits by joining equipotential points. Now I am leaving it as an exercise for you to solve this question by using that alternative method.